Welcome back to the Shtick. In this segment, we have Rabbi Moshe Kahn.
Moshe Kahn is perfect.
We just call you Moshe.
Moshe.
Moshe. Now tell me, what's your shtick?
Well, my shtick is I run Chabad Youth, and I'm here to try and inspire and empower the youth. I think we're living in a generation where kids need to be empowered and told how precious and special they are. And that's what Chabad Youth aims to do, and we hope we're making a difference in someone's life.
How long have you been doing that now?
I've been involved in Melbourne for 14 years. So I was running youth activities before that for years, but in Melbourne, in my current role, 14 years.
And you're originally from London?
Originally from London.
Fantastic. Pom. Well, you're a very pleasant guy, and that's one of the reasons why we've got you on the show, because we like to have a great face for our community, because we're proud of our community.
Correct.
And one of the ways we're proud of our community is by having a street rally, which is going to be happening next week, and a parade. And what are we celebrating?
Well, it's a Jewish festival called Lag BaOmer, which is literally means the 33rd day of the Omer. What it really is, it's a day where, sadly, historically, Jews lost respect for one another. There was division, there was a divide, there was disharmony among the Jews.
Mm.
And we're actually celebrating when the Jews stopped for a second and recognized, so what's going on? We need to unite, we need to be strong, we need to be one. And they re-energized and they refocused and they decided to become together and one. And really we relive that message every single year in Lag BaOmer, where we have a diverse community, which is a blessing, but we've got to remember we're one family, we're one people. And that's what Lag BaOmer is about, bringing Jewish pride, unity, oneness.
And going out into the street is really an illustration of that, isn't it?
Well, it's showing, you know, that we can be proud of who we are, proud of our heritage. It's not something that we have to shy away from. It's showing tolerance for the community, tolerance from the wider community. It's, you know, Australia and specifically Victoria and even more specifically Melbourne is really a very multicultural city. We're very lucky to live in a country like Australia where there's such tolerance and unity among such a diverse group of people.
That's fantastic. There's also a bonfire involved. What's the significance of the bonfire?
Well, the bonfire is also really a fire is a unique, really pretty unique. If you think about it, this is a bit esoteric, a bit Kabbalistic.
Yes.
But it's really quite a fascinating idea. A fire yearns to go up to heaven, yearns to go up above, but yet the wood keeps it down. So many of us have these airy-fairy ideas.
We have aspirations.
Aspirations. Mm. But we've got to be grounded. We've got to get them. We've got to make them a reality. We've got to make them real. And in Judaism, spirituality is taking the most lofty and godly ideas, but bringing them in this world. To say I love you is a bit meaningless unless it's grounded with actions, with meaning, with doing something. And therefore, that's how we celebrate the day, where it's not just airy-fairy, it's not just abstract, but it's something physical, it's concrete, it's real, it's meaningful.
Yeah, and talking about real situations, I just wanted to bring up the current thing that's going on in the community, and that's the commission into child sex abuse. Mm. Now, as the director of Chabad Youth, what's the message you're giving to your young people regarding how they should react to this?
Well, look, the commission is a fantastic initiative, something definitely worthwhile. Sadly, 25 plus years ago, there was real mistakes made in the community, unforgivable mistakes, and something that we can't take back. The community can't ever retract what's happened in the past.
Mm.
But I think, the difference we could make is from today and onwards. What could we do different today?
Correct.
And, you know, being in a privileged position where I interact with literally thousands of youth, I think our role and the responsibility is to educate the kids. There's two levels, educating the staff that interact with the students, with the youth, and educating the youth. And that's really our primary role, to make sure they're educated, to make sure we give them the tools and how to deal, to know what's appropriate, what's not appropriate, what's acceptable, what's not acceptable. And equally, the same parallel to that is to train our staff that they know and have very strict policies, guidelines put into place. And, we pride ourselves in the Chabad Youth takes this matter serious and knowing the difference that we do make and knowing the difference that we do have on students' life, the responsibility that comes along with that to make sure the safety and the welfare of our students and youth.
Well, that's really good. I'm glad to hear that, because we had a whole program featuring Manny Wax talking about it, and a lot of developments have occurred since, and the commission's expected to go on for a couple of years. Yeah. So we've only just touched the surface of it, and I appreciate that the yeshiva movement is doing something proactive to make themselves a lot more facilitated towards being proactive.
100%, yeah.
Well, that's really good news.
Yeah.
And the good news is that we are united, and that even though there are people that are going to always be critical, and, you know, because I hear a lot of criticism about the yeshiva from secular people, and I don't see any reason for it, because I think that we all should be living in a sense as a community.
100%. Look, the reality is that, you know, as I said, sadly, a lot of the negative, if you like, vibe, if you know, it's really from a history which there was a mistake, and no one could deny mistakes, no one could deny what happened, but we're living in a different day, in a different age, and there's no question about it that we as a community, as a whole community, and I'm even talking about not just the Shiva Chabad community, but I'm talking about Melbourne Jewry and Australian Jewry have been educated and have come to learn of mistakes of the past. This is something that's really, really affected the whole Australia. And it's something where I think people were ignorant, if you like. People didn't have the understanding, not justifying it, not excusing mistakes, but just pure ignorance. And I think today we're a lot more educated, and youth are a lot more educated, which is what's important. They understand the rights and wrong. And I think that's what we need to keep reinforcing, keep educating, keep empowering the youth. Give them the tools how to deal with situation, and let them know that they have a right to stand up.
It's a time for revelation.
It is. It is.
Fantastic. To go out in the streets and just say exactly what you think.
100%.
And that's what's going on.
Well, that's Lag B'Omer. It's a day where we go out and we say what we want to say. And we say loud and clear.
Yeah. That's fantastic. It's been wonderful to have you back on the shtick. You've been on before.
Yes, and we love being here. Thank you so much, Henry.
We'll definitely have you back on again. We'll go out with a bit of footage from previous Lag B'Omer parades, and then we'll be back in the last segment with highlights of Yom HaTzmaut and a clip from Rabbi Lord Jonathan Sachs, who has such beautiful words to say.